July 12th, 2015, it's 10:25 a.m. Gonna go out to the garden in a few minutes to show you where I'm getting these from. But they're torch sunflowers. They're also known as Mexican sunflowers. In light of what's going on in the country right now, I will just stick with torch sunflowers. They attract honeybees, butterflies, other bees too, I'm sure, but you know, not a big deal at all. They don't bother us at all in the garden. But you pick off the heads when they get like this here. I didn't have this on tripod, now I do, so I can see with both hands. These are prickly now. They're like cockleburs. And let's see, sometimes if you do this, you might get a couple seeds that fall out. I was watching a video online on how to do it. She took tweezers and she plucked them out gently. And all like that. See, now this one's not gonna cooperate with me. I just kept plucking. Just try and get one out here. See the seed here? Drop it out here so you can see a couple of them there. This one here. And this one here. It looks like a little triangle, like the front of a plane. And there. And this one right here. Okay. And just pull them out from the center. And after you do that, if you turn it like upside down and shake it down, you'll get a bunch of other seeds that'll fall out. Okay. And like I said, the butterflies, they'll attract butterflies, especially the big ones. Like, it says monarch, but I haven't seen any monarchs yet. But like I said, you'll get these seeds. I don't see it right there. Okay. Now, this is what I've gotten so far from only about five heads, or four heads, four flowers. Kind of a little snack bag that's about a quarter full. I accidentally picked this one by mistake. See, it's still got a lot of nectar on there, and I shouldn't have picked that one. I'm gonna see if it'll dry out like this or not. So it's gotta be pointed like this. I'm gonna go out to the garden and show you these flowers. They're really nice flowers. I didn't know what to expect with them. This is the first time I planted them like this. I've planted them before unsuccessfully. And now they're growing and they're helping a lot. Oh, we got a lot of cucumbers. Oh, I'm just gonna fog up here so I'll wipe it with my shirt. A lot of cucumbers, black-eyed peas. See that butterfly right there? Oh, I can't, you're not gonna wait. We'll see some in the garden here. Originally, what I was going to do is just try these and see how they would come up. And I mixed in those tall ones there. Those are those Titan sunflowers, the yellow ones, like in the back there. Some of those are deformed, which I questioned about Fukushima and such. But I mixed them in here too. They don't attract the birds. I mean, hummingbirds come over here, not often, but that would be over here flying around. Bees, honeybees, and these big butterflies. They're beautiful butterflies. And you go in here and you pick stuff and see, like, there's a bee right there on that one there. Oh, maybe just flew off in the wind. But see, as the petals fall off, again, I can't see good. As the orange petals fall off, you'll still see all that nectar on them. You wait until they dry out. I'm gonna see if I can find one. I'm not gonna pull it off because I can't do it with one hand. Yeah, right there's a couple. They're not quite done yet, but you can feel it. It's real prickly. That one still got quite a bit of nectar on it too. So this one too, quite a bit. I got some in the house I've been cutting them. But see, they keep coming back. More flowers come up as you cut off the ones that are done. See, these still have too much pollen on them. Pollen is what I meant. Not nectar, pollen. See? Get over here where you can see the big butterflies. If I can zoom in on them, I can't see on this viewfinder with this cracked lens. Okay. Anyway, there's a big butterfly right there. There he is, flying right there, like that. Come out here, generally there's four or five of mine on the plants out here. Plus you got those, they're technically moths, but they're not. They're pretty. They're a little small. Like I say, the bees fly around here like crazy. See, now these have come off later today. I'll take this one off if you can see it. See, that's pointed. It's like little pins almost. That's when it dries out, when the flowers come off. And like I say, as they fall off, see, this one's dying off. And then there's one right there that's coming out. And these things are, it's helping us with abundance of attracting the bees. See, the different yellow butterflies. I got all kind of butterflies out here. And I'm going to mix those in with those next year, those yellow titans. It won't be as thick as that, the yellow titans, but I'll have these torch sunflowers. They also refer to them as Mexican sunflowers, which, again, like I said, with the way things are in this country right now, I'll stick with torch sunflowers. That's their actual name. And they'll be further away from the garden, coming this way. And then over here, I didn't plant anything. I'll plant some down this one too with those sunflowers mixed in. And this back, what I call the back wall. This is the third garden. There's three gardens, two small ones and this big one. One is the first one right here. Let me get on the front side of the garden, basically, I call it, closest to the house. Boy, it's warm out here. All right, so you got one, we call it garden one, garden two, and then three is the one in the back, the long one. So that'll have the torch and the yellow titan sunflowers all right there, and then a split for the walkway in the middle, and then one in the back. The back will be all those spread out a bit more with the torch sunflowers mixed in. And same thing on this end. It's warm out here. Starting to get hot just from standing out here. Oh, I actually put a few seeds of the torch down here. It should, in about 2 weeks, 2 to 3 weeks, start coming up. And it should, the heat down here, the way it's been this summer, it's been a hot summer. It'll go into October. So it'll grow all of the rest of July, which is two weeks. You got a full month of August and September. So that's like that's 10 weeks at the very least. And if October is any indication of summer, it'll probably be in the 70s more in October than not. So, you got the sunflowers, the titans over on this end. Made a previous video of the deformities on some of these, actually. I'm not going to go over all that right now. I mainly was focusing on the torch sunflowers. Those are torch sunflowers. That's what attracts all the butterflies and honeybees and everything else over here. And help, then they pollinate everything else here. That's why we had such an abundant garden. Zucchini, we got so many zucchini, we're giving them to people constantly. And we still got quite a few. We had some canned, and the cucumber over there, it's just every day you can get at least 8 to 10 out of that part, those vines. I got a cantaloupe I'm gonna be picking here later on this afternoon. About lunchtime, maybe. Get that cantaloupe and I'm just gonna videotape this now. That's the cantaloupe. I'm gonna cut it off and have that for lunch today. We're already down there. Sugar baby, the little round ones, not little round ones, the big round ones look like bowling balls. And then we have one of those oblong ones. You see three in the back there now. We've had one in the house. Oh, that was good. There's a previous video on that one. So, yeah, this is gonna be rearranged a little bit because now we know how everything grows out. We're not gonna plant as many of anything like this. There'll be eight. Right now there's like 12 of these zucchini. We're only gonna plant 8. 4 yellow and 4 black beauty. And they're gonna be spread out in the front gardens. And the beans and watermelon will all be back here. The okra and the okra on the far end over there. And the zucchini will be up on these gardens here. The tomatoes will be over closer to where those are now, but that'll be moved further away too, so. And these were planted about 3 weeks ago. It's different. This is a buttercup squash, just like that small one there. And these are two different types of squash from these and from each other. Cannoli bean finally coming up. That's an heirloom bean, it's hard to get. And then this is the Jackson Wonder bean. These came up really good too. So various peppers and three more tomato plants over there. This plastic makes a big difference. The butterflies and hummingbirds and honeybees all are contributing together, so it's been a really good garden. Next year, if anything doesn't fall apart this year, will be a very good garden too. So at the very least, folks, grow a couple things. Some easiest things to grow generally are, supposed they always say, peppers and tomatoes, although tomatoes have been a bit of a challenge. But you need to grow some food. So that's what was going on. I showed you about how to get the seeds for those for next year. And like I say, all those, that bag of seeds right now is enough to go down that whole side, that back, and up this side, these two sides right here. I say two sides because the garden splits with a walkway in the middle. There you go.